Hey, this is the third video in the tutorial series where we make this animation with a Blender Python script. Hi, I'm Victor Stepanov. I'm glad that you can make it. Let's see what's to come in this video. In this part of the series, we'll be creating a bevel object for the curve. After that, we'll create some shape keys and assign the deform coordinates we created in the previous video. Let's create a mental model of what we want to accomplish by the end of this video. In the previous video, we wrote some code that created a circle and a list of new coordinates for each vert of that circle. Let's think of this part as a single step called calculate deform coordinates. In this video, we'll be starting off by creating a bevel object and assigning it to the curve. After that, we'll create shape keys to control the deformation. We'll need to loop over the deform coordinates we created in the previous video and assign their values to the equivalent shape key data. We'll finish by grouping that code together under the add shape key name so we can reference it later. It will be important to keep this mental model in mind so we don't get lost in the code. You can find the code that we'll be starting off with on the GitHub page for this project. I'll add a link in the description where you can find this page. Look for Start Code. I'll also add a link to the code that we'll have at the end of this video if you happen to run into any issues along the way. We will pick up where we left off in the previous video. We have a script that adds a circle mesh and calculates the new positions of the vertices for the circle mesh using noise. And at the very bottom, it saves it off into a list that we're going to use in this video. We also added a number of empties and icospheres to visualize what we're doing. We want to remove these for now because we don't need them anymore. Now that we removed this, let's run it and see what happens. As you can see, we're generating just the circle mesh, and actually it's a curve if you look over here because we convert it right after this loop. Next, we want to add a bevel object to our curve. But before we do that, let's do this with our hands. It's very important to understand what we're automating by doing something with our hands and then converting that into Python code. I'm going to go up here into the layout workspace. And I'm going to go and press Shift A, add plane. I'm going to right click on this and convert it to a curve. I'm going to scale it down by pressing S and then moving the mouse towards the origin. I'm going to select our curve and go right here on the right, go to the curve properties and select geometry object and then select this plane that we just converted. As you can see, that's our bevel object, and this is what we're going to be doing with Python in just a minute. I'm going to go back to our scripting workspace. I'm going to run our code again. It's going to clean everything and remove, and we can start coding. Let's start off by adding a plane in the 3D viewport, and then going down here into the info panel, copying this command and pasting it into our editor, and removing everything inside of those parentheses. I'm going to convert it into a curve right away and then run our script. As you can see, it's a square curve, and we're going to use that, scale it down, and apply it as a bevel in just a minute. Now, as you can see, I created the plane, converted it into a curve, got a reference to this object that we created, scaled it down by X and Y, and gave it a name. Let's run the script and see what it does. You can see that this curve is in the middle of the scene. we have a name. If you look at the outliner, the same name that we just set right here. And now let's apply this curve object to our main curve. Now let's run it and see what happens. As you can see, our main curve has a bevel object assigned to it. If you're following along with Blender 2.8, don't write this line. It doesn't exist yet for that version of Blender. So you would have this. I'm gonna use it because I'm using Blender 3.0. If you're on Blender 2.9, this line you also need to add. To make this code more readable, let's group this code into a function. I'm going to select the code that's creating the bevel object, hit Control X, go down here and type in def for define create, and then paste the code, fixed indentation right here. Now that we have our function, we need to return this bevel object we created. I'm going to use the return statement. And I'm going to return the bevel object reference. Now let's take this function call and put it instead of the bevel object right here. So now Blender is going to call this, or Python is going to call this function to get this bevel object. I'm going to clean up the indentation right here, just remove extra lines, and then let's run it. As you can see, nothing changed. I'll just comment this out just to show you that it does work. So without this, no bevel object. With this, we're assigning the bevel object. Now it's time to add the shape keys to our curve. But before we do that, if you're learning something new or enjoying this video, make sure to give this video a like. It'll help me tremendously. Now let's select the main curve. I'm gonna click on that. And on the right in the object properties, scroll to the very bottom and find the shape keys. Click the plus sign. This will add a shape key. And on the left right here, we're gonna see the command for adding shape keys. I'm gonna hit Control C to copy it. And right after we're adding the bevel object right here, we're going to paste that command in. I'm going to replace the first part with the reference to our main curve. And I'm going to set the name for this. I'm going to go ahead and copy this so we can create our second shape key for the deformation of the curve. Now I'm going to run the script. I'm going to select the main curve again and look to the right and see both shape keys added. Now we want to apply the deform coordinates we created in the previous video to the corresponding shape key data. So there's a piece of data in the shape key that corresponds to each vert of our curve, and we need to assign the new position we calculated in the previous video. First, we need to get a reference to our current shape key that we're going to be adding this data to. I'm going to create a reference to this shape key, the deform one. Next, we'll need to loop over all of the coordinates we created in the previous video in a for loop. And then assign each coordinate to the coordinate of the shape key data. We need a way to define the index. The index of the data starts with 0. We'll assign 0 to it, and then I'll need to add 1 to index every single iteration. Now let's run this and see what happens. Let's select the main curve, select deform right here, and see what happens when I play around with the value. It's doing something, but not what we want. It looks like it's flipping. To fix that, we need to reverse this list that we created. Let's do that. The reverse just flips the list that we created. Let's run this again. I'm going to select the deform again and just start playing with the value. As you can see, it is working as expected. We can make this loop more compact by using enumerate. So instead of having an index variable right here and then adding it on every single iteration, we can just write this. So I'm going to remove this and this line. Let's run it and see what happens. As you can see, I can still modify this value right here. So it's doing the same thing. I'm going to actually just name this I. Usually you should name these indexes with I, but you can also use index if you want. It's probably more readable. As the final step, let's group this shape key code into a function. I'm going to select the code that creates the shape key and add a definition of a function. So def, then paste the code we just copied. Since we're using references to the curve and the coordinates that we created in the previous video, we need to pass these into this function. So I'm gonna copy this and set it as a parameter. Also, I'm gonna copy this and set it as a second parameter. Now I can select this, copy it, and paste it right here so we can use it. Let's run that. As you can see, it's still doing the same thing. Values changing and the curve is deforming. Finally, let's just return this shape key that we created. For our next video, we're going to be starting to use this to animate the shape key. Notice that when we run our script, main curve is not deformed. I'd like to set it to deformed when we finish. You can do that by setting the value of the deform shape key to 1. Let's see what happens when I run this. All right, don't forget to save your project. If you're enjoying this, make sure to leave a comment or ask any questions that you have.
In the next video, we'll be animating the shape key we created in this video.